up? What is good? Welcome back to The Blind Spot, and this is how I do product shoots for clothing brands. So big thanks to Drone Clothing for lending me some shirts for this particular episode, and Kat and Christine Joy Pineda for being my models. So this is how I start. I make sure to showcase the design, the logos, maybe big or small, like the ones in the cap, like you can see the small thing right there. Subtle, but I make sure to put it in. So that one right there at the back of the cap, I make sure to put it in. One of the big no-nos for me is hiding the design or not showing anything from the brand. So this is a big no-no. You can't really see. It's like a shirt and a beige cap. So I kind of don't like it. So another one is a close-up shot like this, showcasing the logo, and then a few seconds later shift it to a close-up shot showing the logo and the face of the model in a good angle for me. Also, this is a shot that I always prefer, you know, when it comes to like doing accessories and all. I can see the logo, you know, the necklace is not hiding it that much. The logo of the cap, you can see it. A close-up shot like this with the bokeh or something like that, it does help for videos and also for photos. And angles like this, you know, I don't really do that much of like high fashion poses. I make sure that I show the design and make sure that the pose is pretty organic every now and then. Like for this one, it's a busy alley for me. I don't want to fill it up with too much people and make the model pose like that. It's kind of off for me. And for socks like this, the design is around the ankle, so I make sure that I showcase the whole design and not just like D-R-O-N, like drawn. And also, another angle like this, you can showcase this one, is like high fashion or something like that. For me, I mean, it's not the usual poses that I go for. So this one, I made use of the buildings, the grills, so it really helps, you know, adding texture to the shot. And that's pretty much for the first set. And to be honest with you guys, it was really hard at first because the logo is pretty small. The cap's design is just minimal to the, you know, it's a minimal approach. So you have to maximize it and make it look big. Another tip, make sure to showcase the whole logo and not just a hint of it, because it doesn't really translate well to audiences. And you know, like this, it's like drawn, it's not drone. Like for this, I made sure that everything's seen. But one big problem, the one in the lining around the socks is money made me do it, but I could only see money made. So I made sure around, or like a shot going around the socks, or probably a cut to scene. And also, when you're doing some videos like these, make sure to add some organic movements like tying the shoes and also doing some organic poses, not just scripted poses every now and then. It really adds, you know, some personality to the shot. All right, the first few shots was pretty tight, so now let's go for the wide one. This one, I showcased everything, the socks, the logo, shirt, and the cap. And also, I made sure that it's a very big pose, even though the model is pretty thin, so I made sure that she does a big pose like this to emphasize her in the shot for photo and video. And also, I did some transition shots like for this one. You can see it's a really bad angle for me because I'm not showcasing any design other than the cap. So I jumped into the back shot like this and make sure to showcase at least the back or the big back design, even though the cap is not showcasing anything. For videos, this is a manual focus approach by Michael Sacarez. So you can see the logo of the drone right here. And also, you can pan to the socks like this one. A really cool pose, a streetwear kind of pose for me. And it really helped, to be honest. Also, another tip, you know, sometimes bokeh doesn't help with your shots. You know, making sure everything can be seen is also a good approach. It does add some personality to it, to be honest.
Tol, pag nakita mo IG ni Kel, ilan yung inon? Kel, 16 na ba?
May problema, tol, may problema.
Now, playing billiards after wasn't really part of the whole plan, but you know, we went and still played for hours and took shots of Kat here, and it does add some, you know, flavor to the whole shoot, because taking photos of your model doing organic stuff and not just doing, you know, poses and everything every now and then, you know, it really helps the whole set, to be honest.
Sure. Kaya po, pangalawang tatalunin daw ni Lester.
And now, day 2 shoot at El Retrato with Ed Enclona and our model, CJ Pineda. So this is something that I'm not really fond of yet. I'm still getting the hang of it. You know, doing some studio shoots with clothing lines, showcasing products with models. Big thanks to my friends who are teaching me how to do this. And, you know, they've been telling me how to, you know, approach it. So here's some tips that I can share to you guys on how I do it. Big problem for me is dealing with a solid background, a solid color background, and the model itself. You know, I can't really separate them most of the time. I'm dealing with it. I just don't want to do a simple showcase of the shirt, take a picture of it, make the model pose. I know that's a go-to one for, you know, when you're starting, but, you know, down the line when you're working with different brands, you have to do some different approaches. So, you know, you won't serve them different, I mean, similar looks. So first and foremost, I added some colors to the shoot. I brought my Yongnuo 360 Mark II, and I added some colors to the shoot, or added some filters. Like for this one, the AD 8600, you can add some modifiers like this or add some colors like this. This is by Ed Enclona. You can check it out in Lazada as well. 8600, and added some items to the shoot. So adding some items to the shoot, not that much, because when you're adding some items to the shoot and adding some set design, you might as well just do it somewhere else, not just with a solid background. But you know, for me, adding some minimal items, adding it, adds some story, it adds some personality, it adds some texture to the whole shoot, not just a simple photo. So when you add something like unconventional ones, like ladders like this one, lighting them up, or an old stereo for the look, you know, it kind of adds some story. But, you know, I make sure that it is still relevant. Not, I just don't put something into it, you know. Sometimes it kind of kills the vibe. Okay, different angles help, different angles kind of tell different stories. So I'll show you some pictures later how it does help with the whole shoot, okay? So another one is that different angles. Showcasing the product in this kind of setting is still hard, but make sure to help the model pose, you know, showcase the whole design. Like for this one, you're showcasing the socks, the shirt, and also how the model looks. And also incorporating them to the whole set, not just putting the whole items, I mean, whole set of items there and let the model pose. Like for this one, we made CJ step on the ladder so that, you know, kind of looks dominant or something. Put the stereo on top of it, and this is a pretty unconventional one, but we really had fun. This was just a fun concept. We kind of used chopsticks with the chains that I brought and kind of dimmed the lights and added some vape smoke into it. So it was really fun. It was a really fun concept, kind of grungy for me. It added some personality for my shot, so I kind of got used to saying personality, but you know, it's a really cool goal, you know, especially when you're doing some shoots. It kind of gives you more motivation to, you know, put more ideas into your shots. And lastly, you know, don't forget that there's a model. You're not just shooting the products. Use the model to showcase the products with you, not just for you. And also, don't forget to have fun, especially when you're kind of pressured to do like a lot of photos for the brand. So I hope you guys enjoyed this really quick episode. I'll give you guys a quick look at the photos that I took, and also the B-roll. You guys will love the B-roll, right? So enjoy this episode. Don't forget to hit that comment section below, like this video, and subscribe.
Hurt, but I won't cry as long as I give me some closure. Ooh.